Hey guys, did you know that the sea is incredibly deep? The mysteries and wonders of the ocean have captivated humans for centuries. From exploring its vast depths to crossing its expanses, we have always sought ways to overcome the challenges posed by water. One remarkable feat of engineering that has fascinated us is the construction of underwater tunnels. These tunnels not only connect lands separated by water, but also showcase the ingenuity and perseverance of engineers. In this video, we will delve deeper into the topic of how underwater tunnels are constructed, shedding light on the incredible technology and meticulous planning involved in these mega projects. But before we dive in, we kindly ask you to show your support by liking this video and subscribing to Machine Eye. We value your thoughts and invite you to share your opinions on the undersea tunnel megaprojects in the comments below. Now, without further ado, let's embark on an extraordinary journey. When you first enter an underwater tunnel and make your way to the other side safely, it's hard not to feel a sense of awe and wonder. After all, the ocean exerts tremendous pressure at great depths, and even iron blocks can be flattened under such extreme conditions. So, the technology used to build underwater tunnels must be truly remarkable, right? Surprisingly, constructing these tunnels does not necessarily require highly advanced technology. It's all about perspective and understanding the methods employed in tunnel excavation. Let's explore the two main methods used for constructing underwater tunnels. The first method is known as shield tunneling. As the name suggests, this method involves using a shield machine to excavate under the seabed. Imagine a giant iron block resembling a massive drilling head, rotating slowly to excavate the underwater rock and gradually moving forward. These shield machines are unified structures that simultaneously excavate the rock walls and transport the debris to the surface through a conveyor belt system. In essence, they excavate, transport, and advance, all in one continuous operation. However, the shield tunneling method has one major drawback: it is relatively slow. Due to the complexity of the underwater environment and the need for careful navigation, shield tunneling progresses at a slower pace compared to land-based tunneling. Making a few meters of progress in a day is considered good progress in underwater tunnel construction. Moreover, the complex underwater conditions demand great caution, as any mishap can quickly escalate into a critical situation. When the shield machine encounters hard rock formations that impede its progress, explosives may be required to clear the obstacle. However, the clearing process follows traditional land-based methods of digging holes, blasting rocks, and creating a passage. Once the obstruction is cleared, the shield machine can resume excavation and move forward. On the other hand, the second method, known as the cut-and-cover method or specifically the immersed tube method, offers a simpler and more direct approach. In the immersed tube method, large tubes are prefabricated on land and then submerged along a predetermined underwater route. These tubes, usually constructed in sections, are sealed with watertight bulkheads at both ends. Some water inlet ports are also incorporated to facilitate subsequent water drainage during the sinking process. The tubes are then towed by ships to the designated location and carefully positioned into the excavated trench at the crossing point of the tunnel. Once all the tubes are in place, the ends of each tunnel section are connected, and the internal bulkheads are removed. The water is then drained from the tubes, and they are finally removed, completing the construction of the underwater tunnel. The immersed tube method is considered the fastest construction method for underwater tunnels. It offers strong seismic resistance, minimal environmental impact, and a relatively safe construction process. Notable projects such as the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge Submarine Tunnel in China and the Hong Kong Cross Harbor Tunnel have been successfully constructed using this method. However, like any construction technique, the immersed tube method has its drawbacks. One notable challenge is the complexity of drainage and the risk of accidents. Since the tunnel structure is exposed underwater, proper waterproof measures must be implemented to prevent water leakage. Moreover, the tunnel's exposure to the marine environment makes it more susceptible to damage from ship anchors and potential shipwrecks. Although the construction process itself may seem relatively simple, it presents significant challenges in terms of technical expertise and knowledge. For instance, blasting hard rocks underwater requires specialized skills and expertise. It is not as simple as placing explosives and detonating them. Highly trained engineers with postgraduate degrees specializing in this field conduct comprehensive discussions and research, seeking the input of blasting experts to determine the appropriate use and quantity of explosives. The consequences of misjudgment can be catastrophic, resulting in not only casualties but also the failure of a multi-billion-dollar tunnel project. Additionally, before commencing the construction of an underwater tunnel, specialized engineers must thoroughly understand the geological conditions along the entire route. This necessitates extensive geological surveys and analyses, examining each position along the construction route. Furthermore, contingency plans must be developed to ensure that construction can continue, bypassing any difficulties encountered along the way. In conclusion, the construction of underwater tunnels can be considered both difficult and not difficult, depending on the perspective. From a technical and knowledge standpoint, it is undoubtedly challenging and may be hard for ordinary people to grasp fully. However, when we consider the construction methods and the expertise involved, it becomes evident that underwater tunnel construction is a complex endeavor requiring meticulous planning and execution. So, have you gained a better understanding of how underwater tunnels are built? We would love to hear your thoughts and insights in the comment section below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel to stay updated with more fascinating content. Thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video. Until then, take care and bye.